In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how a list can be used to compute the median of a collection of values. If the collection contains an odd number of values, then the median is the middle value when the collection is sorted. When the collection contains an even number of values, the median value is the average of the two middle values. Let's start by writing some comments that describe the steps that we will take to solve this problem. We'll begin by reading several values from the user and storing them in a list. The user will enter a blank line to indicate that all of the values have been entered. Then our program will sort the list and compute and display the median. We'll start by writing the code that reads the values from the user and stores them in a list. I'll begin by creating a variable to hold all of the data. It will be initialized to the empty list. As our program runs, we'll append new values to this list. Then I'll read the first value from the user. I'm not going to convert it to a number yet, because the user is going to enter a blank line to indicate that all the values have been entered. Our program will crash if we try and convert a blank line to a floating point number with the float function. Now that the first value has been read, we can use a while loop to read the remaining values from the user. Our while loop will run as long as the value entered by the user is not a blank line. When the loop body runs, it will convert the value entered by the user into a floating point number and add it to the end of the list by calling the append method. Then the next value will be read before Python goes back and evaluates the condition on the loop. The next step is sorting the list. While we could implement a common sorting algorithm like selection sort or insertion sort ourselves, there is no need to do so. Python includes a method named sort that can be applied to a list. It will use an efficient sorting algorithm to rearrange the elements in the list into ascending order. There are three cases that we need to consider when reporting the median. If the first value entered by the user was a blank line, then the list of values will be empty and there is no median value, so our program will display an appropriate message. If the number of values in the list is odd, meaning that the remainder when the length of the list is divided by 2 is equal to 1, then the median value is the middle item in the list. We need to use integer division when dividing the length by 2 so that the result is rounded down to the closest integer, both to get the correct index and because a list index must be an integer. It can't be a floating point number. Finally, if the list is not empty and has an even number of elements, the median is the average of the two middle elements. Once again, we'll use integer division when dividing the length of the list by 2 because a list index cannot be a floating point number. Let's see what happens when we run the program. Python begins by initializing data to the empty list. Then the first value is read. The first value is not a blank line, so the body of the while loop is executed. Python converts the value entered by the user into a floating point number and adds it to the end of the list. Then the next value is read. The value is not equal to a blank line, so the body of the loop runs again. The value is converted to a floating point number and it is added to the end of the list. Then the next value is read. Once again, the value is not equal to a blank line, so the value is converted and added to the end of the list. This time the user enters a blank line. When Python evaluates the condition on the while loop, the result is false. So Python skips the body of the while loop and goes on and runs the rest of the program. The next line in our program invokes the sort method on data. This causes Python to rearrange the elements in data so that they are in ascending order. The length of the list is 3, so the condition on the if statement is false, which causes Python to skip the body of the if statement and go on and evaluate the condition on the elif statement. The condition on the elif statement is true because the remainder when 3 is divided by 2 is 1, so Python executes the body of the elif statement. When the length, which is 3, is divided by 2 using integer division, the result is 1, so Python copies the element at position 1 from the list into the median variable, and then the median is displayed with a print statement. Then our program terminates because there are no statements after the body of the else. Let's run our program again. This time the user enters a blank line for the first value. The condition on the while loop is false, so Python skips the body of the loop. Then Python calls the sort method. The sort method doesn't have to do much because the list is empty, which means that it is already in sorted order. Python moves on and evaluates the condition on the if statement. The condition evaluates to true, so Python runs the body of the if statement and displays an appropriate message. We'll run our program one more time. This time the user begins by entering four values. Each value is added to the end of the list after it's read. Then the user enters a blank line, which makes the condition on the while loop false, so Python goes on and runs the rest of the program. The list is sorted into ascending order. Then the condition on the if statement is evaluated. It's false, so Python goes on and evaluates the condition on the elif statement. It's also false, so Python runs the body of the else statement. The length of the list is 4, so dividing the length of the list by 2 gives 2 as its result. Python computes the average of the element at position 2 and the element at position 1, assigns that average to the median variable, and then reports the result with a print statement. This video has demonstrated how a list can be used to compute the median of a collection of values. I hope that watching this video has increased your understanding of this topic.